Hey guys, whoa. Thank you for coming out today. How are you guys doing?
Fine. It's a pleasure to see you today.
Yeah, what's today? Today's Saturday?
Yeah.
Yeah, Saturday. I never know what day it is, because I don't really work Monday to Friday, so I have no concept of time anymore. But yeah, Monday's going to be a good day. Who watches originals as soon as it airs? How do you do that?
It's awesome.
And do you have to find like a...
There's something called
Internet. Like a link?
Yes.
Is it illegal?
No.
Isn't very friendly, to be honest. And it's always, it has this really, really high expectation of what we should look like, how we should be, how much money we should make, and what sort of friends we should have. And I think the more you invest in this world, the more unhappy you find you'll be, because it's an unrealistic expectation, you know? And I think often people that are in a situation that is quite grim are looking at things the wrong way, you know? And it's interesting, you're gonna have to talk after me. Do you want to go and then I'll keep going? Yeah, okay, so I'm going to stop and then I'm going to keep talking. Okay, so here's the thing. Every single person in this room, including myself, could pick something out of today that they're unhappy about or they could complain about, right? We all have the ability to be like, oh, it's not fair. This is what I don't have. Oh, why do I have to do this? Or why do I have to do that? But at the same time, every single person in this room, including myself, could always look at the positive and be like, you know what? I'm just so grateful for the things that I do have. You know, for me, I feel very, very blessed. I get to travel the world and I get to do really, really cool things like this. But at the same token, I've traveled with some people that get to do the exact same thing I do and they complain about it. Do you know what I mean? And that's life. That's what we sometimes do and it becomes a habit. And I think the most important thing is to always, and you have to do this every single day. If you want to be a positive person, you have to do positive things every single day for your soul. You know, not for anybody else except for yourself. So it's like, for example, at the end of every day, I try and watch the sunset for at least 10, 15 minutes if I get a chance. And my thing about that is like, even if I've had a horrible day, or even if I had a day where things didn't go my way, where I didn't get an acting job, or I had a big fight with someone that's in my family, or a relationship that I have, or, you know, I lost my iPhone, or something like, you know, or like stupid things like that. You know, you're like, oh, I just had a bad day, or you're just like, you feel unhappy, or you just feel lonely, or you just feel a little bit depressed, yeah? I stop, and I look at the sunset, and I take a moment, and I'm like, you know what? The fact that I can see a sunset means that I've lived another day, and it's another day that I didn't know what I was gonna get, you know, because we only know that we have this day, and then we don't know what's next, right? And we often forget how short life is. So I look at the sunset, and I'm like, you know what, I'm just grateful that I got to see another sunset because it means I lived another day. And I think every person in this room can be grateful for that, if nothing at all. So there's never something you can't be grateful in life. You know, even if you're in a wheelchair, even if you've, you know, you've got an illness or, you know, it stops you from living your normal life, you can still say I'm alive, I've got breath in my lungs, and I still have the ability to experience life. So we can all be grateful for that. So it's like making sure you get back to the very, very simple thing. You know, you don't need $1 million to be happy. You just need air in your lungs. Yeah?
Yeah.
So a couple of things that I've learned, I'm still talking about this question. Right? First of all, the world says that it's like ideal to be beautiful, right? But you see so many beautiful people that are so unhappy. Yeah? So that's not the answer, right? And I've met so many rich people, right? And they say that money will make you happy. But I've met so many rich people that are so miserable. They're so miserable and they have so, so much money. So it's not money either. You know, the only currency that has any real value in this world is what's in your soul and how your soul feels. Anything that you can touch and anything that you can, like, you can feel is just worldly, yeah? And has no real value at the end of the day. The most important thing is to work on what's inside here. How do you make the energy inside your body, your soul, happy? How do you bring that to life? And, you know, from my experience, I become the most alive on the inside when I'm doing good for someone else that I don't necessarily have to do good for, you know? That makes me feel like, wow, that was worth it. And, you know, it's amazing when I get people on Twitter saying, oh, I love you as an actor, and I love, you know, I love your character, Cole. And that's great, but after a while you forget about that. But what you remember is the person that you hear from on Twitter that's like, hey, because of you, I've decided to chase my dream. Or because of you, I've decided to not be so scared about, you know, standing up for what I believe in. And that's so much more rewarding and encouraging for my soul, because all the other stuff is very worldly, you know? So if there is something that's making you sad in your life at the moment, ask yourself the question, like, is it the world telling me that I should be sad about this? Does it give any value to my soul? Because if it doesn't, then I don't necessarily need it, you know? And it's hard. I know you guys come from a very, very tough country. You know, this country is, you know, in Australia and America, they're very, very fortunate. But guess what? Those people are unhappy too, and they have so much more opportunity than probably you guys in this room. You know what I mean? So don't let the fact that you're from a country like Brazil, or, you know, it's not necessarily the Americas and the Englands and the Australians of the world, make you think that you can't have the same amount of happiness. You can have so much more, because you don't need to buy into all the worldly stuff that this world tries to push on us. Basically, it offers you more, but it gives you less. Think about your soul first, okay? last part. Okay. Now, that's all good and well to be said, and maybe a lot of people in this room go, oh, I agree with that, that's right, and maybe sometimes I do get really engaged in this world and I'm not really doing anything for the inside of my soul, right? Now, it just doesn't change overnight, and it doesn't just happen if you go, okay, I want to change today, or I want to do something different tomorrow. Right? And that's the problem, where a lot of people have this, like, they walk into a wall and like, oh, well, I agreed with what he said, and I tried it for a day, and then the next day I was back to normal again. Right?
Mm-hmm.
The problem with that is you have to work on it every single day. It's like if I said to you in the front row, I'm going to give you a guitar, right? And you've never played guitar before, and by the end of the year I want you to be great at guitar. Now, if you only played it once before I saw you again, how good would you be on the guitar? Horrible. Unless you had some natural gift that just blew everybody away. But if you played for 2 hours every single day, and from a year from now, you would be so much better. And that's the same thing as your soul. If you work on improving how you feel on the inside every single day, in a year's time, it's going to be so much bigger and it's going to be so much fuller. Right? And it's going to be looking at the world a little bit differently, because you're not going to be buying into the newest iPhone, and you know that that's not going to make you happy, and you're not going to obsess over, like, well, I need to look a certain way, or I need to have this much money, or I need to have this much status in my social groups. You get past all that and you're like, okay, maybe I need to do something that will help other people, and that will wake me up, and that will make me do more. Maybe I just need to be a good person to my family. Or maybe I need to be a better daughter to my mom, or a better son to my father, you know, and stuff like that. Because the most important thing in life is the interactions you have with people. Everything we do in life is to improve our interactions ultimately. People think, oh, if I make a lot of money, I'm gonna have better interaction with people. I'm gonna have interaction with people who also have money. We can have all these great interactions, but ultimately, you just want to interact with people. Everybody wants to find a partner, and everyone wants to fall in love. Everyone wants to meet someone and have an interaction. It's all about the interactions. So ultimately, life is about the interactions that you have. Now, if you think about just on a daily basis, like, you might have good interactions with your friends, but what about people you meet on the bus, or the train, or at school, or the girl that sits in the corner by herself who hasn't got a lot of friends? What's your interaction with that person like? You know? What's your interaction with the person that maybe no one necessarily wants to talk to, or people look down on? You know? Because they're the people that probably need the help, and they're the people where you can, when you can do good and get good back. And also having a really good energy will attract like-minded people.